All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is Sunday, December 31st, 2023, 7:11 p.m. This will be the last video of the year for me. My name is Kessie Ian Anderson, and welcome back to another edition of Heresy Arc. This is going to be is just an end of the year rant, or make some observations, make some resolutions, I suppose. They're a little overrated. I already started my main resolution back in November. Actually, back in January, I've been doing intermittent fasting for about a year-ish, and it's helped. I've dropped weight, etc. I've been in shape, ridiculously decent shape, multiple times. Then, of course, you yo-yo, let yourself go, don't care. But it's time to recommit. I'm just done feeling blah. So I am of the extreme variety. I always knew that low sugar was a big deal, but this time I'm going all in. So I've been doing carnivore for the last month and a half-ish. I did purposefully cheat for 2 days on Christmas and definitely noticed the difference. So, but I'm not making this a carnivore channel by any means. I'm just doing an update on it. Maybe in about 5 months, we'll see. So the goal for 2024 at my advanced age, I'm hoping to get, I'm going to come close to a six pack. That's the goal. And it will happen. This carnivore stuff for me is pretty easy. I've always liked meat to a degree, and since I have zero confidence in any of the food, I might as well just go all in. So they can biosensor and introduce, according to Bill Gates, we're gonna put vaccines in the food, and that's what they're doing. So whatever, it doesn't matter what you eat, it's all garbage, even if it's grass-fed, etc. But anyway, so 2024 is about to be upon us. My big predictions, they're going to ramp up the division as much as they can. A lot of dupes are going to fall for it. My goal is to not have emotional attachments to anything that doesn't matter. So what matters? This is just my opinion. Your results may vary. Your inner circle, the ones that you actually care about, they matter. Kids, wife, etc. Outside of that, it gets questionable. You have to do your own judgment call. Not to wax religious, but if you go into the Bible, I think we are definitely in a parable of the virgins and oil in the lamp. So for those of you who don't know, 10 virgins, 5 had oil in their lamp waiting for the bridegroom. I'm not saying, the only thing I'm saying the bridegroom is going to be a disaster that the cabal is going to orchestrate. So those who have oil in their lamps will be able to weather it, oil being supplies. So my brother, he pulled an awesome maneuver on my behalf for Christmas, and he bought me a heater, and it runs on propane. So it's a portable, I can move it from room to room if I want. So what's nice is if the power goes out, when the cabal does its cyber polygon, etc., 10 days of darkness, whatever they have planned, maybe nothing will happen, but just having it on hand is peace of mind. Also, I have my little generator. So if I need a shred of electricity, keep a phone on for whatever. So my whole thing is just to be as independent as possible. There's a little thing growing up. For those of you who don't know, I was raised Mormon. There was a song, Oh Babylon, I guess. I can't remember if that's the actual name, but it's all, oh Babylon, we bid thee farewell. Da 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 da. So a lot of people talk about Babylon, one foot in Babylon and one not. What does that mean? What that means to me is sadly, it's an all or nothing. It is an all or nothing. If you are tied to corporations, tied to the grid, tied to government in any way, shape, or form, that's Babylon, period. So I am a big fan of nationalism. I'm a big fan of the sovereign movement, not sovereign citizen. That is an oxymoron. That is a contradiction. The goal is to no longer be a citizen. So I'm going through, I have five copies of my birth certificate. I am taking steps, and let's say they don't even matter. Say it's just straight nonsense, straight bullshit. I don't care. This is to prove to myself that I have taken as many steps as possible to remove myself from this system, to remove myself from this matrix peacefully. So the idea is you have a million contracts starting with your birth certificate that ties you to the state. Everything you sign, everything you do is contractual law. So to break contract is the goal, and there you can do that by filling out a whole bunch of forms. So revocation of election, W-8-BEN form, you don't pay taxes anymore. The goal is to get a diplomatic passport because you are a representative of your own nation since the federal government of the United States is located in Washington, D.C. Our whole entire government in the United States is an actual corporate lie. There are technically two, and the goal is to rescind and remove yourself from the cabal one and then just be a state national, basically. But it's kind of sketchy. It's kind of scary. I haven't gone through all the information. But also in 1933, the government took on all debt. And then the Federal Reserve moved in and has been power playing us and lying to us the whole time that we owe them money. The government, it's all fake. It's all a lie. So they have infinite dollars to work with. And the act of you signing something brings money into power because we are, I would argue, God's children. So it's fascinating, the legalities, but does it matter? It won't matter. You come across a Zogbot Mason who has no clue what's going on. It won't matter. They love their slave chains. Everybody loves slave chains to a degree. So the goal is to try to get off grid. The goal is to try to be as independent in as many things as possible. Problem is, I don't grow my own food. It's going to be a long time before I am situated. The goal, I have a 10-year goal. That by the time I'm a certain age, I will have my house, I will have land, and then I will have been putting assets in place to be as independent as possible. So it's going to be a chore, but that's possible. It is very possible. The only thing stopping it is going to be external factors to myself. External being things that are absolutely out of my control. So the goal of 2024 is to just control what I can control. And I suggest you all do the same. Things that are out of my control, politics. I mean, I don't vote anyway. I do not care. I do not care what they present to me. Ever. It's if voting worked, they wouldn't let us do it. And it doesn't work. And it's all fake. Regardless, period. I have zero confidence in plans, in Q teams, white hats. Nope. It was all to buy time. To allow the digital acolytes and priest class to create the bio-digital convergence on the cyber-physical backbone for the introduction of the fourth industrial revolution. Now that is a mouthful, but that's what I'm going to be doing with this channel for 2024, and it's all based on Noahide laws. Noahide laws are the fundamental schizo-insanity buttressing all of the tech that is coming out. Biosensor tech. Protein tech, metamaterials, optogenetics, transhumanism, your digital twin, internet of bodies, biometrics, biosensors, bioelectric pills, wireless body area networks, medical body area networks, medium access control, and that is MAC addresses, optogenetics, opsins, metagenomics, 6G wireless body area network, biofields, VLC, Li-Fi. All of those are going to be terms that you better become very, very familiar with, because that's the reality of what happened. That's the reality of why they injected everybody. Everybody now has biosensors floating in them. If you took the injections, if you chose not to, you still have chem spray. You still have biosensors in the food, all the goy slop and goy slurp that we eat and drink. We are all infected with this. So it just depends on how much we are infected with it and what they plan on doing with this medical bio-digital surveillance networks that they've created for us. So the telecommunications are militarized. They work hand in hand with DARPA and the DOD and the military. Something is coming. and they are going to do it purposefully. But they're going to orchestrate their false flags. They're going to orchestrate their lies for the media. They're going to use their media to, whether it's Hollywood or whether it is the mainstream lie media, the Judeo-corporate media, they are going to lie to us about whatever is coming next. It's all orchestrated. Even if people lose their lives in these false flags, understand they're still fake. They're still fake in how they were orchestrated, why they were orchestrated, and the end goal for what they're going to do. None of it will ever benefit us, period. Oh, we're going to vote our way out. We're going to lawfare our way out. Nope, doesn't happen. So get your own, I would recommend, defensive posturing in all ways, First Amendment methods, Second Amendment methods, etc. But understand, in terms of when the powers that be go live with whatever they're getting to do, your Second Amendment is only good for the neighbors to defend whatever you have. It's not going to do anything when they hit us with the digital and electronic warfare that they've already been doing to us. So my 2024, I'm going in very, very cautious. Just going to keep working the plan that I have for myself. And just going to keep, keep focus on what, in my opinion, what matters. Things that don't matter, don't matter. Trying to save people, trying to wake people up, doesn't matter. They will do it themselves if the system, they finally realize stuff isn't normal. But I think it's too late for most people to wake up. If some happen to, if there are gleanings in the field, and the Scythemen are able to gather some wheat from the chaff, so be it. I do not accept a rapture event is coming. They are going to present something miraculous to us, but what it will be, I don't know. When it will happen, I don't know. All I know is that between now and 2024, they've hyped it up so much. Now, Epstein information's coming out. Robert Kennedy admitted he's been on the flights X amount of times. Not necessarily to the island, but to other places. And having been a flight attendant, I know a lot can go on a flight. Just saying. Trump, it came out, was on Epstein's flights way more than normal. Six more times than what we knew about. Did he go to the island? So far, no. But again, a lot can happen on a plane flight. Now, how many other names are going to be brought out? Is anybody even going to care? The FBI is weaponized. The DOJ is weaponized. Anybody spilling hopium that there? It's nonsense. Majority of Congress, I will say every single person in Congress is compromised. You are pre-compromised before you can even get a seat to even attempt to be at the table. So when it comes to the three-letter agencies, the intelligence communities, the Five Eyes, Two Eyes, all the different spycraft programs, MI6, Mossad, all of them working together and leveraging our data using digital golems, the AIs, to sift through our metadata, sift through our texts and pics and plant and evidence against us, use our digital trail against us. It's just going to get hyped up. As we have a bunch of people with their TikToks, with their social media, living their lives of drama and gossip about shit that literally has no effect on anything. I mean, sad to say, we are the paranoid, we are the powerless. But we can still take measures that when the bear comes, for you to at least outrun your neighbor. And we'll see if that's even possible. We'll see how big that bear is. We'll see what that bear is. So 2024, it's going to get interesting because they have all the cannon fodder in the world. I made the mistake today of watching John Levi, his latest drop on YouTube. If I want to depress myself and put myself in quite possibly the worst dark place, I watch his videos. It is the most just unbelievable mourn. I mourn, M-O-U-R-N. I mourn. I have the worst sense of loss. I have such a horrific depression that hits because of that. It's not even has to do with the holidays. It just has to do with, I do not accept any history, especially biblical history. I don't accept any narratives that the Judeo-corporate education system, Judeo-corporate media, Judeo-corporate pharmaceuticals, Judeo-corporate everything they've taught us is an absolute bona fide lie because we are the slaves and they hate us. And then when you see what they've done and bastardized and destroyed our architecture, the architecture that has been here and whatever, maybe, I don't know what civil, it wasn't us that created that stuff. And if it was, it makes me even more pissed knowing that those people did not pass down that information and that whoever took its black hand and destroyed the people responsible for that architecture. Oh, it's just devastating. So those magnificent buildings, those magnificent structures of the past all over the world, whatever that civilization was, and if it was a controlled demolition on purpose for their version of a Great Reset to give us the middle finger, well, after my death, I would like to meet some of those people to find out why, and I hope they give me a good reason because I will spiritually give them double middle fingers right to the face. No, it's a horrific atrocity what they have done to architecture and how they've used relativity and subjectivity to blind us to beauty and art. So with that said, Happy New Year. Until next time.